وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله القائل اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر والحمد لله الذي أحاط بحوادث الدنيا والآخرة خبرا وجعل لكل شيء قدرا وأسبل على الخلائق رعايته سترا أحمده على نعمائه شكرا وأسلم لقضائه صبرا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة أعدها ليوم القيامة ذخرا وأستمدها على الأعداء نصرا وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله أرسله إلى البرية عذرا ونذرا فدعا إلى الله سترا وجهرا ونشر رحمته على العالمين نشرا اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأدم لهم أجرا أما بعد إخواني في الله إني أحبكم في الله. I love you all for the sake of Allah, my beloved brothers and sisters. Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he narrated in his Musnad the hadith of As-Sa'b ibn Juthama. As-Sa'b ibn Juthama radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, he graded this hadith and spoke about its authenticity in his kitab Qissatu al-Masih al-Dajjal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا يخرج الدجال. Dajjal will not come out حتى يذهل الناس عن ذكره, until the people stop talking about him and they forget about him and they don't mention him. وحتى تترك الأئمة ذكره على المنابر. So much so that he will not even be mentioned on the pulpits. That's when Dajjal will come out. So I want to say لقد صدق هذا الخبر عن سيد البشر. The Prophet told the truth, alayhi salatu wasalam. And this statement is a reality. If you look at the world that we live in today, if you look at the Aimatul Masajid, what do they do? Taraku dhikra Dajjal. They left off the mentioning of Dajjal. Ala al-manabiri illa man rahima rabbi. Except those who Allah has mercy on them. So if the Aimatul Masajid are not talking about it, then what do you think? Fakayfa aamatihim. What do you think about the general mass and the other people? Rather, some people, هَدَانَ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاهُمْ مَيَ اللَّهُ guide them and myself. If you speak about qiyamah, if you speak about death, if you talk about nar, they start to become scared and concerned and they will stop you. And they will say to you, غَيِّرِ الْمَوْضُوعِ change the story. Why are you always talking about nar? Why are you talking about death? Why do you talk about these things? غَيِّرِ الْمَوْضُوعِ change the story. Change the thing that you talk about. Say something else. Bring positivity to the community. Sahabatu Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to yatadakaruna asharat as-sa'ah. They used to study and learn and talk about and converse about the signs of the hour. Hudhayfah ibn Asid al-Ghifari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentions, he said, ittala'a an-nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alayna. The Prophet came on us. Hudhayfah ibn Asid al-Ghifari saying this. اطلع علينا النبي اطلع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم علينا. The Prophet came onto us. ونحن نتذاكر whilst we were chatting and we were revising and we were talking. The Prophet said to them, ما تذاكرون? What is it that you guys are talking about and revising and you're discussing? They said, نذكر الساعة. What we're remembering is the hour. قال, he said to them, إنها لا تقوم حتى ترون قبلها عشر آيات. The Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, the hour is not going to come until 10 things happen. It's not going to happen until you see 10 things, the Prophet said. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he named the 10 things. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الدخان والدجال والدابة وطلوع الشمس من مغربها ونزول عيسى بن مريم ويأجوج ومأجوج وثلاثة خسوف أما وثلاثة خسوف خسف بالمشرق وخسف بالمغرب وخسف بجزيرة العرب وآخر ذلك نار تخرج من اليمن تطرد الناس إلى محشرهم. The Prophet mentioned 10 things, عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said the hour will not happen, and it will not take place until these 10 things occur and that they happen. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned, he said the smoke, the Dajjal, the beast, the rising of the sun from the west, the descent of Isa ibn Maryam, may Allah be pleased with him, Ya'juj wa Ma'juj, the land slides in three places, one in the east, one in the west, and one in the Arabian Peninsula, and one in the Arabia, at the end of which fire would burn forth from Yemen and would drive the people to the place of their assembly, yani mahshar. The hour will not happen unless those 10 things take place. So that hadith shows us, ma'ashir al-muslimina, that the sahabas, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, they used to discuss these issues. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, in al-fitan, the trials and the tribulations, ala ikhtilafiha wa tanawwu'iha, in its variation and differences, fi zamani, in time, in terms of time, wal makan, of course, in terms of places, na illa anna a'zama fitnatin ala al-itlaq wa akbaraha bi-ittifaq, is what? Hiya fitnatul masih ad-dajjal. The different types of fitna that are going to happen, and of course they are fitna, and of course they are trials and tribulation, whatever time it may be, and in whatever place it may be, the greatest of those fitna is what? أعظم فتنة على الإطلاق is what? وأكبرها باتفاق, by unanimous agreement, هي فتنة المسيح الدجال. It is the fitna of مسيح الدجال. عمران بن حسين رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, سمعت, I heard رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, ما بين خلق آدم إلى قيام الساعة خلق أكبر من الدجال, وفي رواية أمر أكبر من الدجال. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said in that hadith that there is not, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, between the time of the creation of Adam and the resurrection, there is nothing greater than the mischief of Dajjal. Yani, since Allah tabarak wa ta'ala created Adam until the resurrection day, there is nothing greater than the mischief of the Antichrist, yani Dajjal. There's nothing greater than it. ولذلك من أجل ذلك فإن جميع الأنبياء, all of the prophets, حذروا أقوامهم من هذه الفتنة العظيمة, they warn their people from this great mischief. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, what did he tell us? He told us كان, يعني all the prophets, they warn their people from it. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, now for sure, since the Prophet was the last of prophets, it is for sure that Dajjal is going to come out in this ummah. So the Prophet spent more time warning his companions from it. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said, قام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الناس. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he stood up amongst the people. فأثنى على الله, he praised the Prophet, he praised Allah تبارك وتعالى, the Prophet, بما هو أهله. ثم ذكر الدجال. Then he started to mention الدجال. Abdullah ibn Umar is saying this. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, look what he said to his companions whilst talking about الدجال. He said, إني لأنذركموه. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to his companions, I warn you of him. يعني الدجال. I warn you of him. وما من نبي إلا قد أنذره قومه. That there is no prophet who came, إِلَّا قَدْ أَنْذَرَهُ قَوْمَهُ, except that he warned his people about Dajjal. لَقَدْ أَنْذَرَهُ نُوحٌ قَوْمَهُ, نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ نُوحٌ, he warned his people. وَلَكِنِّي سَأَقُولُ لَكُمْ فِيهِ, the Prophet said, but I will say to you about him, قَوْلًا لَمْ يَقُلْهُ نَبِيٌّ لِقَوْمِهِ, I'm going to say to you about Dajjal something that no prophet that came before me had said to his people. يعني, I will tell you a word regarding him which no prophet had told his people, which is what? The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّهُ أَعْوَرٌ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيْسَ بِأَعْوَرٌ. Dajjal, he is blind in one eye, and Allah is not blind in one eye. Okay? That's Dajjal. Okay? The Prophet told us that information, and we know all of the other prophets didn't tell this to their prophets, يعني to their nations. Why is he called Al-Masih al-Dajjal? Why was he given that name? Ibn Athir in his kitab, غريب الحديث والأثر, النهاية في غريب الحديث والأثر, he mentions, he said, فَسُمِّيَ بِهِ لِأَنَّ عَيْنَهُ الْوَاحِدَةَ مَمْسُوحَةٌ. The reason is because he is, one of his eyes, it's ممسوح, يعني it's wiped. Okay? وَيُقَالُ رَجُلٌ مَمْسُوحُ الْوَجْهِ. The Arabs, they say, when they speak, a man, his face is يعني wiped. وَمَسِيحٌ وَهُوَ ال... And it means, أَلَّا يَبْقَ عَلَى أَحَدٍ شَقِيٍ. يعني ألا يبقى على أحد شقي وجهه عين ولا حاجب إلا استوى. يعني this, his face is like this. One of his eyes is like this. Okay. وقيل, some of the scholars, they said, he said, لأنه يمسح الأرض. يعني it means that he يقطعها. He cuts the earth. He travels from one place to another. And the word الدجال, it comes from the form فعال. من أبنية المبالغة is when the Arabs, they go, يعني they exaggerate a point. أي يكثره منه الكذب والتلبيس. أي يكثر منه الكذب والتلبيس. يعني الدجال is فعال من أبنية المبالغة, is when something goes overboard. Exaggeration. The Arabs, when it means that he lies too much and he deceives a lot. So he's used, that Dajjal is used for him. The second point I want to mention regarding him is مكان خروجه ولبثه في الأرض. Where is he going to come out from and where is he going to remain? أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه, he mentioned in the hadith, الإمام الترمذي collected and Ibn Majah and Sheikh Al-Albani authenticated it in his سلسلة حديث الصحيحة, that the أبو بكر said حدثنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Prophet told us الدجال يخرج من أرض, الدجال will come out بأرض بِالْمَشْرِقِ يُقَالُ لَهَا خُرَسَان. That Dajjal is going to come out, what? That Dajjal will emerge in a land in the east. It's called خُرَسَان and will be followed by people with faces like hammered shields. He will be followed. يَتْبَعُهُ أَقْوَامٌ كَأَنَّ وُجُوهَهُمُ الْمَجَّانُ الْمُطْرَقَةِ. He will be followed by people with faces like hammered shields. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us that, alayhi salatu wasallam. But brothers and sisters, him coming out from that land doesn't mean that he will be heard of straight away. His news will reach the people when he's at a place between Al-Iraq and Sham. And when he's in that place in Iraq and Sham, people start hearing about him. And they will know about him. And that he comes out. ولذلك, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, he said to us, إِنَّهُ يَعْنِي الدَّجَّال, the Prophet said, خَارِجٌ, he will come out, خَلَّةً بَيْنَ الشَّامِ وَالْعِرَاقِ. He will come out, he will appear on the way between Syria and Iraq. He will come out. فَعَاثَ يَمِينًا وَعَاثَ شِمَالًا يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ فَثْبُتُوا. And would spread mischief right and left. The Prophet then said, O slaves of Allah, adhere to the truth. Be steadfast, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Sahabas, they said, قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَمَا لُبْثُهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. The Sahabas, they said, how long would he stay on the earth? The Prophet said, أَرْبَعُونَ يَوْمًا, 40 days. يَوْمًا كَسَنَةٍ وَيَوْمٌ كَشَهْرٍ وَيَوْمٌ كَجُمْعَةٍ وَسَائِرُ أَيَّامِهِ كَأَيَّامِكُمْ. The Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, he will remain for 40 days. One day like a year, and one day like a month, and one day like a week, and the rest of the days would be like the days you guys have. The Sahabas, they said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look how concerned the Sahabas were. And the first thing that came to their minds, قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. The Sahabas, they said, oh, Messenger of Allah. فَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمُ الَّذِي كَسَنَةٍ. That day which you mentioned is which is going to be equal to a year. What do we do with our prayer? أَتَكْفِينَ فِيهِ صَلَاتُ يَوْمٍ. Would one salah be suffice for that day? The Prophet said to them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَا no. So what did they do? أُقْدُرُوا لَهُ قَدْرَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say to them? No, but you must make an estimate of time and then observe your prayer. وَلِذَلِكَ the scholars from there, they took a nice fiqh from it. That if you're in a land where the sun is never sighted, it's just going to be daytime. And in some countries like that, that's what happens. Where there's only daytime, there's no night. The sun doesn't stay all time. What do those people have to do? Those people have to make sure that they follow their neighboring country and the time in which they pray because of the hadith. So this gives us what, brothers and sisters? The understanding of where is he going to come out from, which we learned, which is makanu khuruji. We also learned lubthuhu, where he remains in the earth. How long he's going to remain on the earth, which is 40 days. And we explain how the 40 days is going to be. Brothers and sisters, the fitna of Masih al-Dajjal, this man's fitna, how is it going to be? What type of fitna is he going to bring to the earth? I'm going to read a very powerful statement that Al-Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, he said in his kitab, Sharh Sahih Muslim. He says, في قصة الدجال حجة لمذهب أهل الحق في صحة وجوده. The story of Dajjal is a proof for the madhab of the Ahlul Haqq, the people of truth, that it's authentic that he exists. وأنه شخص بعينه, that is a particular person, ابتل الله به عباده, in which Allah tests the people with. وأقدره على أشياء من مقدورات الله تعالى, and that Allah gave him ability of things that Allah gave him, in إحياء الميت, that he can bring life to the ones who died. Allah is going to give him ability, إحياء الميت. He's going to be able to bring life to the dead. الذي يقتل, which he kills. ومن ظهور زهرة الدنيا والخصب معه. And he's even able to bring the earth, يعني vegetations and crops. وجنته وناره. And he's going to be able to even give people punishment and reward. يعني God, he'll be able to take them to a Jannah that he creates for them and a Nar which he makes for them. This is what he's going to be able to do. So he's a fitna. You can see someone who Allah gave him all of that and using it with mischief. Brothers and sisters, if he's able to do that, we need to look at the type of people today that we are. Today, the human beings today, with social media, with everything that's happening, it's definite people will just believe everything he says. And they will follow him. This belief that the Dajjal is a country or is a superpower is khuzabalat. It's confusion and misguidance and turahat. As Noah mentioned, he's a particular person. He's a person. And we're going to see his description, inshallah, ta'ala, bi'nillah al-kareem. From the greatest fitna that this man's going to come out with, number one is, there is a fire with him and a Jannah. معه نارا وجنة. From these are من أعظم فتنته أن معه نارا وجنة. He has a nar with him and a Jannah. حذيفة رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he mentions, عليه الصلاة والسلام, about him, the Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, لأنا أعلم بما مع الدجال. The Prophet said, I know what the Dajjal will have with him. He will have two flowing rivers. That's what he's going to have. One that appears to the eye to be clear water, and one that appears to be to the eye to be a flaming fire. If anyone sees that, let him go to the river which he thinks is fine, which he thinks is fire, and close his eyes, the Prophet says. Then lower his head and drink from it, for it is cool water. The Dajjal has one blind eye, the Prophet said, with a layer of thick skin over it. And between his eyes is written, disbeliever, which every believer will read, whether he is illiterate or whether he is literate. The Prophet told us, alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith ibn al-Iman. He said, أَنَا أَعْلَمُ بِمَا مَعَ الدَّجَّالِ. I know what's with Dajjal. مَعَهُ نَهْرٌ يَجْرِيَانِ. He has two rivers that flow. He's going to have it. Two flowing rivers. The first of those rivers, أَحَدُهُمَا رَأْيَ الْعَيْنِ مَاءٌ أَبْيَضٌ. The first one of those two rivers, it will appear to the eye to be clear water. When you look at it. وَالْآخَرُ رَأْيَ الْعَيْنِ نَارٌ. And the second one is going to look like, the second flowing water appears to the eye to be a flaming fire. That's how it's going to appear to the person. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, تَأَجُّ فَإِمَّا أَن تَدْرَكَنَّ أَحَدٌ فَلْيَأْتِي النَّهْرَ الَّذِي يَرَاهُ نَارًا. That you should go towards the flowing river that you think it's fire. Go to that one. And do what? Close your eyes. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He commands the believers what? وَلْيُغَمِّضْ. Close your eyes. Thumma, the Prophet said, the person should do what? Put your head down and drink from it. Even if your mind or your body is telling you, just go towards it. Drink from it. فَإِنَّهُ مَاءٌ بَارِدٌ. For verily, it's cool water. Then the Prophet said, وَإِنَّ الدَّجَّالَ مَمْسُوحُ الْعَيْنِ. Dajjal, he has one eye. He's one-eyed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And he said, in between it here is written, كَافِرٌ. That's what's written on it. The believer should know that and understand it. Every mu'min who believed in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, who came with real iman, will be able to see that written. Whether he can read or write, it doesn't matter. From the fitan that this man's going to come to, which is number two, he has actions that he's going to do which is going to cause the people confusion. His actions that he comes with. He's able to do actions and things that will confuse the people. The first one is the hadith of Abi Umamah al-Bahili, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, he said, وَإِنَّ مِن فِتْنَتِي, from his fitna is, أَن يَقُولَ لِأَعْرَابِيٍّ. He's going to come to a Bedouin man. He's going to be able to go to a Bedouin man. Now this is a Bedouin man who doesn't know much. Dajjal will be able to come to this Bedouin man and say to him, أَرَأَيْتَ إِن بَعَثْتُ لَكَ أَبَاكَ وَأُمَّكَ. He'll say, if I bring life to your mother and your father who passed away, أَتَشْهَدُ أَنِّي رَبُّكُ. Would you testify that I'm your Lord? Would you accept me as your Lord? فَيَقُولُ نَعَمْ. The Bedouin man will say, of course I would. فَيَتَمَثَّلُ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فِي صُورَةِ أَبِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ. He's going to bring to him a shaytan that will come to this person in the form of his father and his mother. فَيَقُولَانِ. And they will say to the person, يَا بُنَيَّ اتَّبِعْهُ. My son, follow him. فَإِنَّهُ رَبُّكُ. He's your Lord. Yani the two shaytans will pretend to be his mother and his father, and they will say to the Bedouin man, they will say to him, this man, Dajjal, is your Lord, follow him. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, that is a fitnatun, azeematun. Azeematun. Imagine that you believe you saw your mom and dad. Walidharika, brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guided us, that when Dajjal comes and we hear of his yani coming, what should we do? The Prophet said, man sami'a bid Dajjali, فَلْيَنْأَ عَنْهُ فَوَاللَّهِ إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَأْتِيهِ وَهُوَ يَحْسِبُ أَنَّهُ مُؤْمِنٌ فَيَتَّبِعُهُ مِمَّا يَبْعَثُ بِهِ مِنَ الشُّبُهَاتِ أَوْ لِمَا يُبْعَثُ بِهِ مِنَ الشُّبُهَاتِ. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you hear of Dajjal coming out, the Prophet said, فَلْيَنْأَ عَنْهُ, run away from him. You hear people today say, "Akhi, why? Why don't I listen to the shubuhat? I want to hear it. I'm a strong mu'min. I can defend myself." No, brothers and sisters. No. When you hear of trials and tribulations and fitan, فَلْيَنْعَ عَنْهُ, run away from it. For wallahi إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَأْتِيهِ, the Prophet said that a man will come to Dajjal, وَهُوَ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّهُ مُؤْمِنِ, he said, "I'm a mu'min. I can defend myself." فَيَتَّبِعُهُ, and he will be, and then he will be, Dajjal is going to show you so much shubha, you're going to follow him. That Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, the great scholar, he said this hadith is similar to the situation of the innovators. If you know of an innovator, run away from him. Get away. Why listen to him? Why give your heart and mind to him? Why do you let him regurgitate? Why would you, he heard that shubha from someone else and he's going to read it on you. Why are you going to listen to him? And many people do. They go on YouTube and they watch people's shubhat and their doubts. Don't listen to them. Avoid them. Stay away from them. Also from the fitna of this man is fitna to istijabati samai wal ardi li amrihi. The samawat and the ard are going to they're going to follow his request. Ay na'am. He's going to be able to do that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, فَيَأْتِي عَلَى الْقَوْمِ فَيَدْعُوهُمْ. What he does is, he would come to the people and he would invite them to a wrong religion. He call them to deviation. That's what he does. فَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ, they believe in him. وَيَسْتَجِيبُونَ لَهُ, and they start to obey him and listen to him. فَيَأْمُرُ السَّمَاءَ فَتُمْطِرُ. And then he would what? He would speak to, he will command the sky, and the sky will send down rainfall upon the earth. And then it would grow crops, which would normally take a long time. لَا فَتُمْبِتُ, it will bring it out. فَتَرُوحُ عَلَيْهِمْ سَارِحَتُهُمْ أَطْوَلَ مَا كَانَتْ ذُرْعًا أَمَ ذُرًّا. The crops that used to take a long time, the pasture, all of it quickly. They'll be able to do it so fast and so quick. Brothers and sisters, the rain that just came down, it will produce crops. Then in the evening, their pasturing animals would come to them with their humps very high and their udders full of milk. Their breasts are full of milk and their flanks stretched when he comes. He would then come to another people and he would invite them, but they would reject him and would go away from them, and there would be a drought, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, for them, and nothing would be left with them in the form of wealth. He would then walk through the wasteland and say to it, and he's going to go to the earth. That's nothing. He would say, "Bring forth your treasures." That's what he'd say. He's talking to the earth. He will say to the earth, "Bring forth your treasures." And then the treasures would come out and collect themselves before him like the swarm of bees. When the people see all of this happen in front of them, and they're amatun nas, the people flocked him. That's why the Prophet told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to stay away from him. Now that being said, brothers and sisters, Dajjal is something we need to, there are many other things that the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, regarding him. What is it that we need to do? What is it that we should do in order to protect ourselves? The Prophet told us, he will never just tell us Dajjal like that, except that he will tell us things that we need to do. Reciting the 10 verses, or the 10 first verses of Surah Al-Kahfi. The Prophet said, "Man hafidha 10 ayatin min awwali Surah Al-Kahfi usima min ad-Dajjal." Anyone who memorizes the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf, he will be protected from Dajjal. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another hadith, فَمَنْ أَدْرَكَهُ مِنْكُمْ, anyone who sees Dajjal, meets him, فَلْيَقْرَ عَلَيْهِ فَوَاتِحَ سُورَةُ الْكَهْفِ, recite Surah Al-Kahf on him, the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf. Also, brothers and sisters, Hadith Zayd ibn Thabit, that the Prophet said, تعوذوا بالله من فتنة الدجال. The Sahabas, they said, نعوذ بالله من فتنة الدجال, which is to ask Allah to protect you from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. By asking Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to what? To protect you from him. سُكْنَا مَكَّةَ الْمُكَرَّمَةَ أَوِ الْمَدِينَةِ النَّبَوِيَّةِ. Living in Mecca and in Medina protects you from Dajjal. And it's a fortress. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentions, لَيْسَ مِنْ بَلَدٍ, that there is not a land, إِلَّا سَيَطَوَّأُهُ الدَّجَّال, except that Dajjal will go in it. إِلَّا مَكَّةَ وَالْمَدِينَةِ, except Mecca and the Medina. ليس له من نقابها نقب إلا عليه الملائكة صافين يحرسونها ثم ترجف المدينة بأهلها ثلاث رجفات فيخرج الله كل كافر ومنافق. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he mentioned in this hadith, there will be no land which would not be covered by Dajjal, but Mecca and Medina, there would be no passage out of the passages leading to them which would not be guarded by angels arranged in rows. And every path to Mecca and Medina, they will be guarded by angels. Then he, the Dajjal, would appear in a barren land adjacent to Medina, and it would rock three times, yani Medina, and that three, yani earthquakes or yani rock, all the unbelievers, the disbelievers, and the hypocrites will get out of Medina from it. وَفِي الْخِتَامِ, finally, my beloved brothers and sisters, I ask Allah تبارك وتعالى, اللهم اغفر لنا خطايانا وجهلنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وما أنت أعلم به منا. اللهم اغفر لنا جدنا وهزلنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا. أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير. اللهم رب جبريل وميكائيل وإسرافيل فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة, أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. اهدنا لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك, إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم ومن عذاب القبر ومن فتنة المحيا والممات ومن شر فتنة المسيح الدجال. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمده, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.